Did you know there are two primary anxiety pathways in the brain, the amygdala and the cortex? Let's start by looking at the amygdala pathway to anxiety. The amygdala is one of two almond-shaped structures located near the base of the brain. It mediates many aspects of emotion and memory. For example, Janet was sexually assaulted in a nightclub when a specific song was playing. Years later, whenever she hears that same song, Janet experiences an increased heart rate, sweaty palms, muscle tension, a surge of adrenaline, and the desire to run away. This is called the fight or flight response, and it's outside of your conscious control. Now, a song is not dangerous, but Janet's amygdala made a negative association and created an anxiety response. One of the primary roles of the amygdala is the formation and storage of memories associated with emotional events. This is called emotional learning. It's useful to remember the language of the amygdala is based on association, so a sound, smell, texture, or place can all become negatively associated with danger. The amygdala is your protector. It's on the lookout for anything that can cause you harm. But it takes its role of protector very seriously and often overreacts. Amygdala-based anxiety seems to come out of the blue with a strong physiological response. It can appear way out of proportion to the situation and can often feel illogical. Let's now look at the cortex pathway to anxiety. The cortex is the outer layer of the brain and operates in a completely different way to the amygdala. It allows you to produce language, use your imagination, interpret situations, and attribute meaning to events and sensations. For example, Tony recently applied to Oxford University, and one morning he noticed an envelope on the doormat with the Oxford University watermark. He imagined it was a rejection letter and had the thought, "I'm a failure." He then imagined never getting a job and being homeless. Tony's cortex initiated an anxiety response by predicting future events and imagining their negative consequences. To clarify, if you have an immediate bodily response to anxiety, such as trembling hands, muscle tension, increased heart rate, and rapid breathing, that suggests it may have started in the amygdala. Whereas if you're overthinking and focusing more on thoughts, interpretations, and creating future scenarios, that suggests your anxiety may have started in the cortex. It's not always easy to identify, as cortex-based anxiety can trigger the amygdala and vice versa. Understanding where and how your anxiety begins will allow you to engage in the most effective treatment strategies. If your anxiety begins in the amygdala, you can benefit from creating a state of calmness in the body by slowing down your breathing or learning a muscle relaxation technique such as progressive muscle relaxation. Exercise can also reduce the activation of the fight or flight response. Now, if your anxiety originates in the cortex, you can benefit from a cognitive behavioural therapy technique called cognitive restructuring. This basically involves identifying and challenging your unhelpful thoughts. Now, a personal favourite is the diffusion techniques from acceptance and commitment therapy. Now, these help you unhook from unhelpful thoughts and recognise that thoughts are not facts, they're simply passing mental events. I'd also suggest mindfulness, as regular practice can train your cortex to mindfully observe rather than react. Now, I've put links to all of these exercises in the description below. And if you've enjoyed this video, you may be interested in the video on the screen now. And I look forward to seeing you soon.